The purpose of this video is to briefly overview the concepts and vocabulary for the harmonic oscillator. So on the left side of the screen, I have a frame-by-frame overview of one oscillation. This oscillator has been released from rest at a position of x equals plus a, and that a is called the amplitude. Because the spring is stretched beyond its equilibrium length, it's going to pull this mass to the left and cause it to accelerate. The mass then accelerates right through the equilibrium position where the spring force is zero. And because the spring energy is zero there as well, that's where we reach our maximum kinetic energy and maximum speed. The mass then continues to the left until it gets to a minimum position, and you should notice that's exactly the same distance from equilibrium as it started, just on the opposite side. So now it's at a position of negative A. The mass has come to rest there, and now it's going to accelerate back toward the equilibrium position, again achieving a maximum speed on its way through the equilibrium position, and finally it will come to rest again at x equals A, and then the cycle just repeats. Now, of course, if there's friction, the amplitude starts reducing, but we're not considering friction right now. So the time it takes for one of these oscillations is called the period. And as it turns out, that period is equal to 2 pi root m over k, where m is the mass of the oscillator and k is the spring constant. Now that I have the period, I can quickly write down the frequency because it's just the reciprocal. And I get 1 over 2 pi root k over m. Next, I want to think about any energy issues going on in the simple harmonic oscillator. And of course, the kinetic energy at any moment is 1 half mv squared. And the potential energy at any moment, that's in the spring potential energy, it's 1 half kx squared. And provided we don't have any friction, the total energy is going to be a constant. And at any moment in time, that's given by 1 half mv squared plus 1 half kx squared, and it always adds up to the same number. A convenient way of finding the total energy is to look at this starting position where the mass is at rest and it's at its maximum displacement from equilibrium. There, all the energy is spring potential. So I could write down E total is equal to 1 half kA squared. Sometimes we're interested in finding the maximum speed of a harmonic oscillator, and that's just an energy conservation question. I could say the total energy is in the kinetic system when the speed is maximized. And that happens when the mass is passing through the equilibrium position where there's no spring potential energy being stored. Solving for Vmax, I divide by m and square root both sides, and I get square root k over m times the amplitude, which might be a handy formula. And the last thing I want to do is the maximum acceleration. Well, that occurs when the spring force is maximum on the mass, which happens when x is at plus or minus a. So F net is going to be given by Hooke's law, so it'll be kx, but x is equal to a. And F net is equal to m times the acceleration. And I quickly solve for my maximum acceleration, and I get k over m times the amplitude. So let's apply some of these ideas to a multi-part question. In my question, I have a harmonic oscillator with a spring constant of 10 newtons per meter, a mass of 315 grams, which I'm going to change to kilograms, 0.315, and an amplitude of 22 centimeters, which I'll change to 0.22 meters. In part A, I'm asked to get the period and frequency of the oscillations, so just plug into the formulas. Period is 2 pi root m over k, so 2 pi root 0.315 over 10, and I get 1.12 seconds for that. Frequency, I could just say 1 over the numerical value of period that I just got, but I'll go ahead and plug into the formula just for practice. It's 1 over 2 pi root k over m. And I get 0.897 for that. Now, what are the units of frequency? If frequency is the reciprocal of period, the units must be 1 over seconds. In other words, oscillations per second. But there's a special name for that. That's a hertz. Part B, compute the total energy in the oscillator. That's 1/2 Ka squared, so 1/2 times 10 times A squared. I change the amplitude to meters, so this should come out in joules. And I get 0.242 joules. Part C, compute the maximum speed. So we'll just use the little formula I derived, Vmax is root K over M times the amplitude. Finally, we want the maximum acceleration. And again, I'll just use the little formula I derived. That's just from applying Hooke's law when the position is equal to plus or minus A. Now, if you're wondering where that formula for period came from, that comes from solving a differential equation in order to find the equation of motion of this oscillator, and I'll cover that in another video. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.